We are on number 69 out of 117 scriptures in the Old Testament that every single person should know. I want to talk with you about comfort. Have you ever had a moment where you really needed comfort, where you felt broken, where you just felt like, you know, you didn't have a reason to go forward and you just needed some comfort from someone? Or maybe there was somebody else that is in your life that was just, you know, completely shattered and they needed somebody to lift them up and comfort them. Well, I want to talk with you about how God speaks to his people in the book of Isaiah. And to give you a little bit of context, the Israelites, when they sinned, they were taken out of their land. They were completely, you know, they lost their identity as a nation. So the entire northern kingdom just disappeared. And then the southern kingdom, Judah, was taken into exile for 40 years. Many scholars believe that in light of what happened to the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, Isaiah is talking about how God wants to comfort his people. So let's take a look at Isaiah chapter 40. Are you ready? Isaiah chapter 40, verse 1. Comfort. Comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that her warfare is ended, that her iniquity is pardoned, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level and the rough places a plain, and the glory of the Lord be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. These words are so important, my brothers and sisters, because notice that comfort is connected to God's forgiveness. When a person understands God's capacity to forgive, that God desires to forgive, God does not desire the death of the sinner. He desires that the sinner repent. Then they understand how much God wants to comfort his people. John the Baptist said that he was the voice crying out in the wilderness. When you read the Gospels, you see that this message of comfort is connected to the ministry of John the Baptist, and it reaches fulfillment in the ministry of Christ. And so my question to you is, do you know the comfort of God? Do you know where to go when you need comfort? Turn to our Lord at those moments when you need to find comfort and say, Lord, give me that comfort. Show me how to turn away from sin. Show me how to follow you faithfully, and you will find it in Christ, my Lord, who gives comfort. So my brothers and sisters, consider what Isaiah has to say. Spend some time in prayer and, you know, turn to the Lord for comfort. And when you find others that need comfort, just go up to them and say, look, God will give you the comfort that you long for. Just turn to him.